Okay, so Apple has finally rolled out the version 5.1.2 for the Apple Watch Series 4. And this is a major update since the ECG feature has now been activated in this Series 4. And but since the feature is only applicable for US citizens, and since I have purchased this watch from the US, hence even I get to see the ECG feature. So let's start the video. So as you can see, if you go to the all applications, here you get to see the new icon, which is of the ECG. So once you click, you have to set it up, and here you see the icon of your heart, and then it shows you hold your finger on the ground. Actually, I've set it up, and the setting is very easy. It took around half a minute or a minute. So after setting it up, it will look like this. So you have to hold your finger on the ground, for example, like this, and it will measure for around 30 seconds. So the result came out to be inconclusive, and this isn't the first time. Actually, I have already tested out for the first time when I updated the device, and it also came to be inconclusive, and now again it's coming inconclusive. So I don't know what's the matter. I've also seen many YouTube videos where many YouTubers have complained that they also received the ECG to be inconclusive. So I guess Apple needs to fix it out. So it's saying that if you're feeling unwell, you need to consult your doctor, and Apple Watch cannot check the signs for a heart attack. If you believe you're having a medical emergency, contact emergency services. So if you want to add any symptoms, you can add it and press done. So this was in the watch. So now let's go to the application on the phone. So now let's go to the health application where the ECG data has been stored. So once you open the application, you will get to see the setup menu. You just need to enter your date of birth, and it should be a minimum of 22 years old, I think. So you have to set it up, and then you get to see the ECG data. So I have two readings, one which I measured when the update was installed, and the second one is the current one. So as you can see that the both readings were inconclusive, this one as well as this one, both are inconclusive. So I don't know what's the problem. I guess there's a bug. So this is the reading, the time, and the device details. And the good thing is that you can export a PDF for your doctor, so you get to see the name of the patient, the date of birth, the heart rate, the graphs, and the graphs are really detailed, as you can see. So it's really helpful for the doctor to consult and check whether what's wrong with your heart rate and all. So this was regarding the data, and then as you can see, you have categories, for example, all data, which is two, and out of which both of them were inconclusive. So you have the sinus rhythm, the atrial fibrillation, the low and heart high rate. So this is what is an ECG, how does the application work, and results you may see, and you should know. Yeah, these are the things which Apple has mentioned, that it cannot detect a heart attack, it cannot detect blood clots or a stroke, and you need to consult your doctor if you face any issues. So yeah, that was regarding the ECG feature, and I hope that Apple comes out with the update for the Indian users too. But yeah, it will take time because of the government approval and all. So yeah, that was the ECG feature. Now talking about some of the more improvements is that if you go to the control center, you get to see the the walkie-talkie on and off options. So you get to see a shortcut over here. And talking about the shortcuts, you get to see some of the additions like the phone, the ECG, and some more. Let me show you. For example, you have the maps, the messages, and as you can see, after the update, I have noticed that the animation gets a bit choppy. So I was going to mention that, but as you can see that it gets a bit choppy. So you have the phone, you have the messages, you have the maps. So you have tons of applications which you can customize and add to your home screen. So yeah, that's the final improvement which I saw. So the operating system is still really seamless and all, but yeah, just talking about the shortcuts which I told you, that was the only lag which I faced after the update. So regarding it, it's completely fine, it works seamlessly, no issues regarding it, just the choppiness which I noticed. So that was regarding the update, and if you like the video, hit that like button, and if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button, and I hope to see you in my next video.